And now for today's Bible question. Today we have been learning about how Jesus was condemned and crucified by wicked men. We saw how Pilate wanted to release Jesus, but in the end gave way to the wishes of the crowd and ordered Jesus to be beaten and put to death by crucifixion. Someone might ask the question, why did the Jews cry out for crucifixion and not stoning, as the Jewish law demanded for capital punishment? In the book of Acts, we read how the Jews took Stephen, a disciple of Jesus, and stoned him. This is what the law of God called for as the mode of capital punishment when the crime called for it. Neither Jesus nor Stephen did anything worthy of capital punishment. But still, the Jews were so furious with Stephen that they dragged him out of the city and stoned him to death. With Jesus, their intentions were far more cruel. The Romans devised crucifixion to be the most agonizing and horrific type of execution imaginable. The Jews were so determined in their hatred against Jesus that they not only wanted to see him executed, but utterly humiliated and put to shame, suffering to the greatest extent possible. It is hard to imagine why they would treat Jesus so viciously. But we must realize that Satan is hiding in the shadows, leading these men in their hatred toward the Son of God. When the soldiers scourged their victims, they would use a leather whip that had bones and pieces of metal tied to the cords. This weapon inflicted great gashes into the back of the victim, so that not only did the skin open, but the flesh began to tear away. It would have been horribly painful, as well as creating much blood loss. It is said that some victims died from scourging alone. When they nailed Jesus to the cross, they pounded nails through his flesh and into the cross. While hanging upon the cross, it would have been most difficult to even breathe, as the weight of the body was pulling the victim downwards. It is likely that there was some kind of crude seat fastened to the cross so the victim could rest his weight upon it. The victim was stripped of his clothes and hung entirely naked for all to view. The punishment was designed to provide the most shameful and painfully slow death as was possible. This was to warn others not to defy the Roman authorities. The Jews probably looked at this in general with much disgust, for their own scriptures told them that cursed is he that hangs upon a tree. However, in the case of Jesus, the Jews seemed very happy to have Jesus suffer such a disgraceful and horrible death. Even while he suffered on the cross, they taunted him and mocked him. Most movies that have tried to depict the sufferings of Christ upon the cross have fallen short of what it really meant for Jesus to suffer as he did. He was beaten so bad that you could not even recognize his face. Most of us would look at his sufferings and bleeding and feel the utter shame and torture was far too excessive, and our hearts would be moved by compassion for his sorrow and pain. But we must realize that what Christ endured at the hands of men is only part of the story, for the Bible tells us his soul was made an offering for sin, and it pleased the Lord to bruise him. God placed the weight of judgment for all of man's sins upon him while he was on the cross. This explains the anguish of his soul when he cried out, "My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?" The cross, as shameful and devastating as it was for our Lord, is the means by which God can save our souls. As we think about what Jesus endured, not only at the hands of wicked men, but also what he suffered by the judgment of God for our sins, we must solemnly consider what this means to us personally. If Jesus went to the cross and died to put away your sins, then it would be very tragic if you miss out on the salvation he intended to gain for you through his sufferings on the cross. May the Spirit of God help you to see how much God loves you and how much he wants to save your soul. As you take time to think carefully about Jesus' death for you and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Philippians chapter 2, verse 8.